Good evening, everybody.
Hello.
We certainly miss our dear brother and sister Brock and Teresa. Keep them in prayer. For tonight's scripture reading, I'm going to read from Psalm chapter 2. There is actually a reason why I'm reading this.
No.
If you're not familiar with this, you will be shortly, I'm sure. But I thought, with everything that's going on today in the world, and we got Washington, D.C. doing what it does best, bickering and doing everything for themselves and not for the people, which certainly was not, you know, what our nation was all about. It was about listening to the people and finding ways to come together. And at least at the beginning of our nation, the Bible was certainly huge in its influence of how we legislated and how we lived our lives. But there is something we can take assurance here as we read. There's a part where we see that how God looks at the nations. It doesn't matter if it's a little tiny Qatar, or if it's the huge nation of Russia, or China, or the United States, God treats them all the same way. We're going to see here shortly just how God uses, and really this is why we should humble ourselves before this Almighty God. In another passage it says that God sees the nations as, does anybody know, he sees them as a drop.
As a what?
A drop.
We mean a drop.
In the
ocean?
Water drop. As
rain?
A drop in the bucket.
Oh, okay. Bucket.
So as little water drops in a bucket, that's how God sees the nation. So imagine how he sees us as human beings who occupy these nations. All right, let's go ahead and read Psalm 2. Why do the heathen rage, and the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, Let us break their bands asunder, and cast away their cords from us. He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh, the Lord shall have them. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath, and vex them in his sore displeasure. Yet have I set my king upon my holy hill of Zion, and will declare the decree. The Lord hath said unto me, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. Ask of me, and I shall give thee the heathen for thine inheritance, and the uttermost parts of the earth for thy possession. Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron, thou shalt dash them in pieces like a potter's vessel. Be wise now, therefore, O ye kings, be instructed, ye judges of the earth. Serve the Lord with fear, and rejoice with trembling. Kiss the Son, lest he be angry, and ye perish from the way, when his wrath is kindled but a little. Blessed are all they that put their trust in him. Amen.